Hello, my feathered friends. My name is Peacock920. I'm not 100% sure what to expect, but this is Day Shift at Freddy's 3. I want to hear it. This is Dave instruction tape, apparently.
Why, hello there, future entrepreneur. Congratulations on purchasing the Start Your Own Freddy Fazbender's Pizzeria Location Kit, 1993 edition. I am your friendly company representative. I am not a child murderer.
Sure.
Freddy's is a chain of fast food joints that span the entire of America. At its prime, Freddy's had over 50 active locations, most of which were permanently shut down due to a suspicious number of toddlers going missing on our premises. How crazy is that? I'm sure glad that I've had nothing to do with any of that. You, good sir, are a young visionary who bought the Freddy's merchandising kit for a hefty fee of $12.50.
Nice.
The first step of setting up a successful Freddy's pizza joint is to choose a suitable location. And not just any cardboard box will do. Small enough that mysterious giant scugglers can't lay eggs in your restaurant undetected. Trust me on that one. Secondly, you need at least two rooms. A room for dancing in, and a room for bleeding out in. Don't splurge on buying a location. Also, save yourself a headache and avoid carpet. You'll thank me later. Next, you need ingredients for your pizza. The nearest dumpster will do nicely. And want your pizza to have that distinctive Freddy's taste, don't you? Next, you'll need performers. Robots are expensive. So just buy a fat doggo for $20 and call it a fucking day. Or, better yet, fish something out of the trash. Don't attempt to murder any kids that are buffer than you are. Don't put the rabbit's face on a goddamn pizza. Taxation is theft. Don't pay taxes. Don't dropkick any screaming toddlers. And don't the facts during business hours. That's all I have for this date. Goodbye, future restaurant owner. And remember, you are the new face of Freddy Fazbender's Pepperoni.
What? I can't read that. I couldn't read it fast enough.
Why, hello there, future business owner. Welcome to your new Freddy's location. Like all Freddy's locations, it's probably a complete dump.
Sure.
But, rest assured, with enough business savvy antics, you'll be able to afford running water in no time.
Yay.
Your Freddy's issued camera panel should now be sent to your restaurant current layout. Depressing, isn't it?
Love it, yeah.
Most beginning Freddy's locations have at least two rooms, a dining area, and a safe room. This is your dining area. If you were lucky, you had enough money left over after buying the place to afford tables. What kind of lucky fellow would choose to start up at Freddy's location? Hey, don't worry, with time, you can upgrade everything from the floors to the walls, to the moss on the walls.
Upgrade the moss.
Dream
walls.
Big, think of better moss.
Yeah. Hello, Freddy.
This is your safe room. It's an off-camera room where employees can smoke, complain about you without getting fired, and put on horrendous mascot costumes. Springboard suits are hard to come by these days. So, you're probably gonna be serving birthday cake in a bear onesie for a while.
Probably.
friend Nato, entrepreneur. Soon enough, you can buy death traps, and then hire young adults in older ages to die them.
Sure.
Freddy. Now, let's draw paperwork. Sign all of it right now. You will put it in it, and sign it all later, at your leisure.
What?
Now, first things first. You have a fuck ton of big red letters at your disposal. What name are you gonna slap onto your restaurant?
Second. Bear.
Good choice, I'm guessing. Now, we've also included several cut-out Freddy's heads who go above the nape of your pizza joint. Corporate didn't want me to throw in this Fred Bear cut-out, since we accidentally took it mid-chunk while he had a kid in his mouth. But since I'm the only one here now, I put Fred Bear's head in the damn pile. So, choose wisely.
Usually it's just Freddy Fazbear.
You just made the partially irrelevant choice.
Okay.
With all of that out of the way, it's time to go outside, put up your back, your bare head, and call this place open. Goodbye, and remember, you are the face of Freddy Fazbear's pepperoni.
Did I go the right way? I was supposed to put on the Freddy head, wasn't I? Nice. Customers actually showed up. Next month. Oh boy. It's cake time.
Hello, this is the Los Angeles Police Department. Am I speaking to the owner of Freddy Fazbear's Pizza?
Yeah.
First of all, may we ask for your name, sir?
Oh.
Okay, thanks for that. Glad we have that straightened out. We need to ask you another question. Have you heard anything about what happened outside your restaurant today? Basically, a child named Jacob Adams got abducted outside the new Freddy's location. at around 5 p.m. No witnesses were close enough to fully make out what happened. And the reports that we've gotten so far are totally outlandish and paranormal. We know that you were inside when it happened, and we're just calling all nearby businesses out of courtesy. Please, be vigilant. Something is outside your restaurant, and it has already taken one child away. Make sure to lock up tight, and to keep a close eye out. Good night. Stay safe.
Dave must be afoot. Dave, you purple sausage.
Restaurant owner.
This is one of the
Look,
place.
I'm gonna level with you. I don't know what you're gonna hear these texts in, but all I know, Afton Robotics has closed its doors, and no new robots are being made. What? All of that aside, why would you want to spend money on brand new robots when you're just gonna get children's blood and buffalo wing sauce all over them a month after purchase? What you should do is cut corners. Cutting corners at the cost of customer safety. Why, that's the American dream.
No.
So, here's what you need to do. Grab a phone book, and look for the nearest abandoned Freddy's location. Most of them are abandoned, as of me recording this, so unless they are bulldozed, or burnt down, you've got easy pickings. Go to whatever location you can get to, find your way inside, and then take the most complete robot you can. Shine, those old things might be dangerous, but wanted.
Well, if you base it on previous games.
What? You'll save a fortune. And besides, customers love those fucking things. Nothing beats Eddie's nostalgia.
Sure.
Worry not, future restaurant owner. If anything goes wrong, you can always just relocate and change your name, right? Sure. After all, what kind of man buys a Freddy's location and uses their real name? Anyway, that's it for this tape. Goodbye, and remember, you are the funky face of Freddy Fazbender's pepperoni.
Sure. I guess we go around. More here than I did last. So I've been here before. I'll search the north. Curtains. Let's look inside the curtain room. Oh my god. Let's look at Withered Freddy here. Boy, very sure I've seen better days. I'll even be. Let's take a look around and see what else we got first. Freddy seems a bit damaged. Suddenly, Freddy is following me. Search the south. Because I have a limited time, it looks like. I think I recognize what sound's playing in the background. Search east. Rather, we'll search west and then south. announce that. Oh my goodness. Spring Freddy. But that looks like it'd be the best one to go for. Let's go west. Probably the mangoes over here. Oh my goodness. Toy Freddy. Leave him be, poor guy. I'd like to take them all. Search one more spot. Because the Spring Freddy is not a working animatronic, so I could probably put that in. The south facing corridor has been blocked off with a pile of rubble from a collapsed wall. Okay, we're gonna go back to the east and take that Spring Freddy, because it shouldn't be haunted with anything. That balloon boy is staying here. Savage. I'm gonna take Spring Freddy. That's a good one, because Spring Freddy is the one that we used, and no one was put inside it. Since they passed. Oh. Maybe late. You know, there's something that you need to take care of first. Sleep later. Flip side sequence. Interesting. Up and running. It's time. This is your last chance to find their souls. Last chance at redemption. Our last chance to give those lost souls their happiest day. I've already done that in the first game. You have to go inside. What do you mean by that? Pause.
You have to go inside.
Pause.
Oh. Oh.
Here we are. Wherever this is. Guess you'll just have to take a look around. This flip side is a hostile place. Save often. Menu screen.
Okay.
If I have to, I'll save. I'll reload. Is that Bonnie?
Old sport, is that you?
Old sport?
You know, old sport, I never thought I'd see you here. Since you saw this end, all.
Thanks?
Okay, time to spill the beans.
Alright.
Right now, we're standing in the realm known as the flip side. It's a place where dreams come to die, and lost souls eat pizza and stuff. Basically, you've left your timeline, and come to a place outside of your own reality. The flip side.
What?
The flip side, as it is currently known, is a place where lost souls retreat to. You didn't? You left the damn fax about 12 times while it was haunted.
No, I didn't.
Please tell me that you didn't actually think that a sentient child's mind was inside that fax while you were doing the do. The flip side allows souls to remain intact, even if a soul's vessel commits an atrocity in the name of vengeance. Okay, stuff a night guards into suits, buy another kids, being called for a brother blue testicle by workers. That's too much for a child's mind to bear. Over time, souls tend to retreat to the flip side. And as a result, their vessels become more bearable, which is why I'm here. I've been here for years. To be honest. Or, some form of me has, at least.
Okay.
Here's a word of advice, sportsy. Never try to put a soul back into a corpse. Especially not over and over again. Never ends well. For the longest time, I always wondered, why don't all ghosts do this?
Uh-huh.
I know now.
Alright.
Years and years of clinging onto my own dead body has caused my soul to rot and tear itself apart. The more reasonable side of me has retreated here. More or less.
Sure.
I have no clue where my feral side has got him to. It's still out there. I bet. It usually comes back. It always does.
Uh-huh.
No, other than us, there's only stray souls hanging around here. But then again, I'm not exactly sure if I'm what you'd call alive. And we ain't neither. Actually, that's exactly why you're able to move between the flip side and reality.
Okay.
The flip side is a place for souls to physically move around. If a normal human ever tried to enter here, through the glass of that arcade machine, their old soul would push back against the glass, like a reflection on the other end of a mirror. Without a soul, nothing can push you back through the glass. You can come and go as you please. Interesting.
Okay.
I haven't really kept up to date on what's going on in reality. I last checked that around the early 90s.
Yeah.
Granted, I could easily take a gander at what reality they've seen. Let me check. Okay, I see darkness, 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 kebab, darkness.
Kebab.
Okay, I think I'm eating a kebab in the dark. You know, it's actually quite fortunate that you decided to come here tonight. Something eerie has happened.
Uh-huh.
Do you remember the real Fred Bear?
Yeah, I remember him.
He's a bear, not a robotic bear though.
Right.
Like an actual real fucking grizzly bear, wearing a purple bow tie and that. Right. I think he's the embodiment of childhood, or whatever.
Uh-huh.
Good, good. Anyway, he went fucking AWOL. Well, being a non-literal entity, he spent quite a lot of time here, with the lost souls. Watching reality, waiting for the right time to jump in and fight evil. What? Right. He hasn't been seen here in quite a while. He left one day, and never returned.
Oh.
I don't know what exactly went down in reality. What? Something bad clearly happened to Fred Bear.
What was with the smile?
This place has been extra screwed up since then.
Oh.
I've tuned about 335 guitars, made a few dozen pizzas, rugby tackled most of the robots at least once. I'm just really bored, to be honest. Say, if you're going, perhaps I could join you. I could use a friend here. I'd like that, Sportsy. I'd like that a hell of a lot. Think about it. You have some kind of quest to go on. I'm bored enough to do whatever painful task you set me to.
Alright.
It's a win-win situation. Besides, there's robots afoot. You're gonna want me around to help fight them off, right? Oh, this is gonna be so much fun. It'll be like a slumber party, except we're fighting 7-foot-tall animal robots and searching for dead people.
Sure.
Nice.
Ah, look who it is. The rabbit. Seems so weird seeing it, with her face. I swear, one of these days, I want to scribble over the face of every rabbit poster in here. They just look so wrong, you know?
Yeah, I don't know.
Wait, I only remember seeing you at two locations where Bonnie was a no-faced chump. Where was the trade?
Huh.
Ah, right? Did I work there? I see. Okay, let's keep moving. I swear, I see this cabin at every location I wake at. Why does it look like that? Actually, on second thought, I see it every location you wake at. Strange. Let's keep moving. Just remembered. I left my lunch bags in the supply closet. At some point, we should make our way over to the supply closet. Let's just keep moving to the right, and hope we'll eventually hit it.
Okay. Oh.
Tried to erase Fred Bear from the company after the bite of 83. Covered up every damn post that he had up. Serves them right, I think. for purchasing such an accursed character in the first place.
Uh-huh. $999 damage. What's up here? Oh, an office.
The security office? You know, some Freddy's locations are actually designed to run out of power. I know that. I used to leave text for night guards. The idea was that if the robots had a fair chance hunting the night guards, they'd tire themselves out at night and wouldn't amp out during the day. Of course, you and me know the robots are the least of your worries during the day. Yeah. Who cares about bloodthirsty stuffed animals? Let's talk about getting spring locks up the urethra.
Yeah. Yeah, please never say that again. It's gonna be an animatronic. I guess we go to the right then. This way.
Fredbear. You know, after the company bought the Fredbear character from us in 1983, I decided to invent this little fella as a way to antagonize them. My own C. Even snuck these cabinets into their arcades. Oni never figured out how to deactivate them. So he just put passive-aggressive messages into the game. Good times.
Come on. They will remove 100% of escaping combat. Oh. Nice. We'll stop here. If you're enjoying this playthrough, let me know by hitting that like button down below. If you're new to the channel, subscribe, share the video, ring that bell to get notifications on when I upload. In the comments, leave a suggestion to mods, games, other things like that. I plan to go back to the previous two games after I beat this game and see about going through and getting all the endings. But first, I gotta beat this game. Eventually, we'll come back to this game after we beat the other two and see all the endings this one has. For now, peace.